Yep.
He wasn't even using a sub. And he ends up getting the blood on Mac, but I believe he gets naded to all hell here.
After he survives these nades, I thought it's over. And next thing you know, Sib finds a grenade and a sniper pit.
I thought right here it was over. I thought they got info on this guy, P2. I thought Pred was just going to fly at him. They get him weak, crossing back P2. I thought that was the round. And instead of flanking, Simp goes back through their side.
Yeah.
Which ends up being a god play. Just because they probably think he's just pinching at this point.
Yeah. I mean, right here... 2v3, you have to assume that FaZe at the disadvantage, right? Sib finds a big 2 to give him numbers advantage. And what unfolds is pretty nutty, especially because Pred, I believe, has 16 at this point. He dropped 16 in a map 5, 17 or 16.
Against FaZe.
I think it was 16 in a map 5 loss.
And this play out of Simp was also insane. Simp runs through bottom orange, knowing that they're probably going B with the bomb. He just runs, he takes his timing, and he just gets out, and he ends up getting a kill out of it. And then, obviously, we know what's next. This is...
Dude,
I mean,
oh
he just got
God.
Deleted.
He was weak,
that
too. He was
insanity.
Got
that was like a Thanos snap where he saw him, and next thing you know, he was
insane.
Gone.
Dude,
for 5 years.
He's 35 health right here.
Yeah.
I mean, he's 35 HP.
Every bullet hit.
And
Pred was making the right play, right? I mean, he hears someone's weak. You know, this guy's going
to
run back right in front of me, orange. Like, I'm about to go get this trade
for
free.
He's
weak.
Yeah.
This is free. Next thing you know, he gets shotgun to hell. That's one of those unlucky things where you can't fault Pred at all. And I can almost guarantee that Simp was even shocked by getting that kill.
Yes.
And FaZe get it done. So
look at him.
I think there's a real argument to make that Surge probably should have won that series in a reverse sweep fashion.
What the fuck?
But.
I mean, look at
an insane sequence of events. Yeah,
yeah,
I mean, how can you?
You
got a feel for them because that comeback would have been insane.
The tournament's different. Yeah. This was in the winter semis. This is a completely different layout of the tournament, and that's why we kind of talk about how Call of Duty is just so fragile. Imagine that goes the way of Seattle.
Yep.
How different does the tournament look?
You can make an argument for Surge making a tournament run and winning the tournament there. I mean, they beat FaZe in a fashion like that, reverse sweep, a confident team like that with a player like Pred, a player like Sib. They're a good-ass team. And somehow, some way, FaZe clutches that up. And
the way the league's set up right now.
I mean, I don't even know what to say about that.
I do want to say I'm happy for the Seattle guys. They're obviously receiving a lot of flack. They had a pretty turbulent stage two, especially in search and destroy.
They had an awful stage two.
They had an awful stage.
Yeah, no, that's a tough way to go out,
It's just like last year, man. They have a terrible stage, which makes no sense for a team of that caliber.
That's a loose
fold. And it gives them that wake-up call. They start taking practice more serious. They all start hitting the form individually and as a team. And now they're contenders once again, I think. Like, I think they can beat any team, at least in respawns, and their searches have looked a lot better. No one is playing Surge like they were in Stage 2 and go into that saying, oh, we're playing Surge. You know what I'm saying? Like, they are contenders again.
Next, we've got our final map of the deep dive. We're going to take a look at some of the grand finals. Let us know if you guys want to see Search and Destroy.